Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. All Thanksgiving long, I'm going to be giving out why I'm thankful videos. So, for this one, is why I'm thankful for the Karate Kid series. This includes all three Karate Kid movies, the Daniel LaRusso ones. Hell, I'll even probably throw in the next Karate Kid, just cause. And, yeah, even Cobra Kai. I think one of the biggest reasons that I'm thankful for Cobra Kai, and one of the reasons that I explained in the Cobra Kai Kid YouTube video that just came out today, is that it holds a special place in our hearts, us the fans. And it's really something that it's just beautiful to look at. I love seeing where these characters are now, and it's definitely a movie for the fans, and I think we can all appreciate that. Cobra Kai has a very special place for us that really, like, it's just lovely, and I love it with a burning passion. I think another reason why I love Cobra Kai is because, obviously, Daniel LaRusso and Johnny Lawrence. You cannot have a show without them that's centered in the Karate Kid universe. I love seeing Daniel and Johnny have this self-growth throughout the series, and it's very compelling to watch, and it's very satisfying, too, seeing where they were back in 1980 and where they are now. It really gets you hooked in. You really love it. It's awesome. Cobra Kai also manages to just be badass. That's like the one word you can describe the show in. Things I'm grateful for The Karate Kid. The Karate Kid's a great movie, and I think any idiot in a suit can tell you that, too.
Hey, Karate Kid's a great movie. It's the story of a hopeful young karate enthusiast whose dreams and moxie take him all the way to the All-Valley Karate Championship. Of course, sadly, he loses in the final round of that nerd kid. But he learns an important lesson about gracefully accepting defeat.
Karate Kid was so iconic that it lives on to this very day. Hell, The Karate Kid got some great jokes in the TV show How I Met Your Mother.
Every premiere, when I came on screen, I wasn't a bad guy in real life, just a kick-ass actor. No one got that. It happened everywhere I went. Somehow, people always had popcorn.
I mean, come on, William Zabka becoming Barney Stinson's best man is just, it's hilarious.
Will you be my best man? Sure, thanks.
Hello?
Mom? No, listen. I just became somebody's best man.
You can come to Thanksgiving this year.
This show is so iconic that it lives on, and you get to see all these great cameos and all these great little jokes and tidbits, and it's amazing. I really love Ralph Macchio, the character of Daniel LaRusso, even if sometimes he could seem like a whiny little prick. Karate Kid also manages to give us the best that they have of William Zabka. And now with Cobra Kai, we really get to see Johnny's story just expand, and it's amazing. Elizabeth Shue is great as the love interest. I really, really love her. And I was really shocked to see this when I rewatched Drake and Josh, that the actress of Mrs. LaRusso plays Josh Peck's grandma in the show. As for The Karate Kid 2, The Karate Kid 2 was amazing. I love seeing more of Mr. Miyagi, played by the expert Pat Morita. Mr. Miyagi is an amazing character and one for the ages. Pat Morita and Ralph Macchio's chemistry as Miyagi and Daniel feels really, really real. I can't literally believe how real it feels. It feels amazing on how real it is. I always love seeing great chemistry in movies. Not all movies do it too great.
My whole life, I felt like there had to be something more. And then I saw you. And I knew I was right.
But most movies do. I love how it takes Mr. Miyagi back to his homeland and he brings the kid with him. He gets to experience that culture and we do too. Daniel's still a very enjoyable character and Chosen gets his time to shine in Cobra Kai Season 3. The Karate Kid 3. The Karate Kid 3 is actually... I'm not sure. I used to notoriously hate this movie, but I actually found some enjoyment in it. I love how aggressive Mike Barnes is. This is something that Daniel's never gone up against before. I also really love Terry Silver when he's not talking about toxic waste. Miyagi's still a badass, and Daniel's still one of the most enjoyable parts about these movies. The next Karate Kid. As much as I don't like this movie, I will admit there are many, many things that I enjoy in it. I really hope to see the character of Julie show up in Cobra Kai sometime, hopefully Season 4. Even though I kinda hate this plot, I gotta admit, it is pretty fun to watch Miyagi go to a bunch of guys in the mountains. It's very entertaining, as always, to watch Miyagi train the kid. Also, he name drops Daniel, so that's terrific. And that's all the things I love about the Karate Kid saga. If you want to know more, then maybe I'll do some reviews in the future, but for now, that's all I got. Happy Thanksgiving, and my next video will be why I love Titans, all the things I'm thankful for DC's Titans on HBO Max. I hope this Thanksgiving we can all be grateful for the Karate Kid saga, and until next time, I'm Adrian McManus, you've been watching Magic Rock 1.